What's up, everybody? My name is One of the Blind Blade. Welcome to Let's Play Kerbal Space Crobram, the demo version. A little three guys just floating in space. They're like, "Yeah, everything's good, man. We were just abandoned here, but hey, the moon's coming around the Earth, so we'll be fine." So, I have actually put about 5 hours of gameplay into this game, and I haven't tried like all ship versions yet, but I kind of wanted to, and I wanted to record my reactions to some of them. There's a couple that I haven't really tried yet, and some that I don't remember if I did or not. So we're just look, guys, just their faces are just like, "Hey, everything's good. You know, all's good. Everything's fine." Oh, we're going to we'll start now. Demo. That's not. Oops. I'm used to start being like on the left. That always throws me off. I'm not really worried about saves at the moment. All right. So in the demo, you are very limited. You get one command pod. This is basically where your crew hangs out. And then over here, you got some fuel tanks and engines. This is the most powerful engine right here, like medium, and then smallest engine. These are other fuel tanks. That's a booster, but I never really used it. One of the first things that I discovered that you really need is advanced SAS. So if you get this game and you don't put the SAS on, you're gonna be in some trouble. All right. So now we need. I'm just gonna like I had kind of have a little design in my head. Hang on a second. 1 minute here. There we go. And I'm playing with a trackball, so don't mind like the. It's harder for me to do it with the trackball, but it was a lot easier than my previous mouse. Okay, this one. So what this is gonna be a stage rocket. What's gonna happen is, yeah, so let me put something here. There's an engine in this canister right here. This one right here, right in the middle. And what's gonna happen is I'm going to set it to where this engine will go, and then there'll probably be some engines like around it. Like, let's see, six. I'm gonna put some decouplers, I think is what they're called, on here so that they detach, and then this is gonna fire, and then eventually it's going to detach again, and this will break away and reveal an engine in the main part. So I'm going to need some of these. This is not gonna go well, I just know. Also, another thing that can get very annoying very quickly is, for some reason, these right here don't always work. Or they work, but like it's hard to put fuel tanks on them. Usually you have to put something smaller so that like it registers or something, but usually you can get it on there, but I'm seeming to be having some trouble. Actually, hang on a second, I just had an idea. Alright. Take gummit. You just gotta fiddle around with it for a couple of seconds. Alright, I'm gonna cut it to when I get it on there. And we're back! Look at that! Had to switch to 4 because it didn't want to put 6 on there. So then what we got these on, and then I'm gonna set it to where they break off after they run out of fuel. One of the few things that you'll need is nose cones, because it makes it to where it's, you know, not a flat object moving against a wall of wind. I know that doesn't make any sense, but suck it up. And you're gonna need some wings. Like, that is like the one thing you will need above anything else. I'm probably gonna have to cut it again so that I can put this on here. Alright, propulsion. Take your helmet. Oh, there we go. Ha! Alright. This is gonna be bad. Oh, there we go. Okay. This is gonna be very bad. I don't trust this. Alright, if you go into utility here, you'll have a parachute. This is a must-have if you're trying to land. I can't land anywhere, like, on the moon or anything, because I can't, I don't, it's just a demo, so I can't really do that. And I'm pretty sure there's a way you can do it, but I don't know it. So we're just gonna test this and see how it goes. Hang on a second. This is the one thing you will need. Oh, you know what I forgot? These are like, as soon as I discovered actually how to use these, my rockets started staying together more often. Because this is what would happen. They would just, like, they would just start wobbling and just fall apart. Alright, now I gotta set up these stages. Let me see, these will fire. Hang on. I'm trying to find the... Let's see. Okay, this needs to be... It's sometimes it's hard, especially, yeah, sometimes it's hard to see, like, what is what, so I'm trying to figure it out. Okay, so this is those, that is, I can't tell what that is. Is this for, I don't know what that is. Yeah, like, I'm putting it over and nothing green is showing up, but, oh, wait a minute, I thought this was something. Oh, maybe not. Alright, we'll just leave it like that. Alright, this will fire with the rest of those. Ah, here we go. Okay, this is where this is. I don't know what that is. This will need to be... Hang on. Need to add another. Here we go. That will be right there. Those engines will fire. And those will come off. And this will start. Alright. Now I gotta put the structural things on there. Does not look stable at all. They're completely crooked. Alright, yeah. Always be sure to put the structural on the first stage, because I made that mistake with the very first rocket I made. It did not go well. So, anything else I need? I can't really think of anything, so let's go! I'm so excited to see how this goes. Oh, man. I love this game so much. I wish I had the money to buy it, but money's kind of tight right now. I do not like it. Don't worry, Jebediah, you'll be alright. I'm gonna get you through this, Jebediah. Alright. So, yes, I know all the controls. T is SAS, or I don't know all of them, but shift is throttle up. And space! We have liftoff! Man, I'm going fast. Are all the engines firing? Yep. Sweet. Jebediah's like, woo! Yeah! Everything good! I'm so glad I became an astronaut! Well, you know, there are several failed attempts that we've had, Jebediah. I don't care! I'm going to space! There you are. Oh, I forgot to put some wings on the top, but well, this is doing fine. Oh, I'm not gonna be able to steer this thing. And just so you know, this thing is very hard to steer sometimes. Because you have to, like, make adjustments to this part right here, which is the... I can never remember what it's called. But this is a bit... I can't remember what it's called. But then you make, like, minor adjustments, like forward, backward, sideways, up or down. You know, stuff like that. Alright, well, I'm almost out of fuel, so I'm gonna need to... Oh. There we go. And out of fuel on those. And fire! Sweet. Now, since that detached, we are much lighter, so we are going much, much faster. That was actually a rocket I made one time, where it was just basically a bunch of other rockets around, like, something just like this. And it didn't have a lot of fuel, but it went so fast that it didn't matter. So now we're approaching six... Wow, we're going really fast. I'm not really trying to accomplish any objective here. I'm just trying to see how high I can go, because I don't really, like I said, I don't really remember all of my rockets. Like, all the failed attempts and successful attempts. I remember some of them, but not all of them. And if you press M, you can go to orbital view, and as you can see, the Earth is growing a ginormous wart. That's basically, we're going to go straight up, there we go, straight down. If I had angled it, say, that way, forward that way, I would have, it would have changed. It would have had more, width to it. And we're out of fuel. And I forgot, whatever. Now, we got to 3,000, over 3,000 meters a second. That's pretty good. And we're still climbing. So I'm gonna go to orbital view. Okay, we left the atmosphere. And I don't know where we're going. Oh, crap. I didn't count on that. I thought we were going to straight up and shove it down, but apparently... Oh, I know what's happening, and that's pushing us. Jebediah, you might be in some trouble. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Oh, man. Hey, maybe he'll get in, maybe he'll get in an orbit around the sun. And my dog just walked up to me. Hey, puppy, what are you doing? Maybe that actually happened to one of my ships one time. I was actually aiming for the moon. Let me zoom in here. I was actually aiming for the moon. I was like, okay, you know, launch at this time, stuff like that. Actually, I just kind of winged it, but I went straight forward, and then I slingshotted around the moon, and just went, man, zoom, and I just got an orbit around the sun. I don't remember the pilot. I think it was Bill was the pilot's name. I was like, well, Bill, sorry. So, on one of my saves, I just had a guy just orbiting the sun, like, just no problem. And what had ended up happening was when he first slingshotted, he just went up around the sun and went back to Earth and then orbited again. Like, he just went back and then got caught in the sun's gravity. That's what happened. So, we're going to fast forward the warp here a little bit to wherever we're going. Well, the ship... Oh. Gotta throttle the ship down. There we go. There. Nah, that's too slow. We are now in orbit around the sun. This went better than expected. Look at that. We have full orbit around the sun. Oh, I wonder if we're gonna ram straight into the Earth. That would be so hilarious. Oh, God. I'm starting to run out of time, I think. Yeah, I think I'm getting close to running out of time. Oh, man. This game just flies by. I want to see really quick if... I will... Nah, I'm not on the first pass. Pass. There needs to be a faster... Like a deep space option. I don't... Yeah, you can only just go around the solar system. Okay. I was wondering if you could... go around... The... like to other planets and areas, but apparently not. Jebediah, how you doing? He's doing fine. Oh, excuse me, had a little bit of burp there. Well, I think that was I think that was a good first attempt. So, thank y'all so much for watching. This has been Warland Blindblade. Tune in next time. This is great. This is hilarious. Tune in next time. Bye-bye.